What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you the best settings for LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga for low NPCs and laptops to improve your performance and still keep a great visual quality. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. Open up The Skywalker Saga and navigate to your gameplay options. Here, you have the option to make the game a bit easier to play by enabling the full recovery and automatic health recovery options. The full recovery will prevent you from losing stuns when falling into hazardous areas. You might want to disable the analytics preference option, which is enabled by default. This will collect and send information while in-game and can have an impact on the network performance. Below, change the camera, flight, and aiming options to your liking. You can always change these settings while in-game to make sure that they correspond to what you prefer most. Under Aim Assist, all of these settings will be enabled by default in order to make it easier to aim and lock on targets. Some players prefer to disable Aim Assist options as they might have an impact on the precision of your aim. Most users will have a better gaming experience when simply leaving these options enabled. The controller configuration enables you to change the controller layout for the game. The same goes for the keyboard config. In your audio options, you have the option to change the volume sliders for the master, music, sound effects, and dialogue volume. You can also change the subtitle text size, as well as the dialogue box text size below. These options will come down to personal preference. In your video settings, make sure to set the screen resolution option to your native monitor resolution. Below, disable the window mode and borderless options to get the most performance. It's set to windowed for me as it's easier to be current. Below, you have the option to disable VSync when playing in full screen mode. This can help improve your frame rate but might induce screen tearing. Set the shadow quality to low and disable anti-aliasing. If you have some performance to spare after applying the next tweaks, then feel free to increase some of these settings to get a better visual experience. You should set the ambient occlusion and screen space reflections to low for now, and make sure to disable image sharpening, which will otherwise require a high-end graphics card to run smoothly. The HDR output option should be disabled by default. Enable this option if you can make use of a HDR display. Next, in your display options, change the minimap option from static to rotate, which will turn the minimap with your movement, always pointing where the camera faces. This, as well as other minimap settings below, will come down to personal preference, and you should play around with these settings while in-game. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.